Hi guys, Rick here with Bite Me Box Tip-Ups. This is going to be your assembly video for our panfish tip-up. So we'll get right into the parts that we have on this. And what we have is, what you're going to have is three thumb screws. So there's one here, and one here to hold the reel on. You're going to have two flat washers, 1/4 inch. So there's going to be one here and one on the other side as well. The four legs, obviously, they go like so, like you can see in the picture here. And then you'll have the three of the wing nuts. And that's going to be one here to hold the legs on, one here to hold the legs on, and one to hold the reel on. In between the reel and the bracket, you're going to have a 1/4 inch lock washer. You'll have a flag bracket. And you're going to have two of the 3/4 inch machine screws and two of the locking nuts, and that holds your flag bracket on there. Okay, as far as your counterweight, you'll have one of those in there that just snaps on really simple onto your flag. Okay, and then you're going to have a 3/16 screw protector in there. What you're going to do is cut about 1/4 inch off of that. That's going to serve as your support for the ball. And then on the top, that'll be the rest of the cap will go on there to hold the ball on. Now, it's very important that you Gorilla Glue this on, because if you're hard on your equipment, and most guys are, that cap can pop off if the ball gets hooked on something. If you would happen to lose it, you can get these at Menards. It's a 3/16 screw protector. They sell them there. They're very cheap. So not the end of the world if you lose it, but make sure you do glue them on. So that's pretty much the gist of putting these together. It's pretty easy. We'll talk a little bit about setup. What I like to do when I'm on the ice, we're just going to simulate that this is the hole. So basically you're putting that, so you're straddling the hole like that. One thing I like to do is actually tip that board back just a little bit. You can go straight up with it or whatever, but it just seems like it works really well if you give it just a little bit of an angle back like that. And you can go even more if you need to, but what you're doing with this to set it, so if you have our boxes, we talk a lot about swiveling that reel to set the sensitivity. It's not so much with the panfish tip up. These, you're pretty much just setting that reel to wherever you're most comfortable. If you're going with the light setting, then you want to set that reel a little bit farther back. Like that, and this is where tipping the board back can kind of help you with that. So then you can do this, and more so with these counterweights for the light setting, you're going to slide it pretty much all the way back. And then what you're doing with your thumb is you're just rolling that reel, the handle, so it's just barely hanging on there, and you can really roll it so that thing is just barely hanging. So when that fish just breathes on it, it goes up. You won't deal with the wind trips and everything else with it. So that's one of the things you're going to want to monkey around a little bit with it. If you want to go with the hard setting, leave the counterweight farther forward, and then you're going to extend that reel even farther out. So now if that fish hits, he actually has to pick the counterweight up. So you can set it as hard as you want or as light as you want. And then wind up at the end of the day, there's a clicker on the side. Push the button up, cinch it up, put your hook in the cork. And I recommend on these to put the hook underneath, on the back side, because when it's sticking out here, it seems to get hooked on everything. I also keep these in a little plastic cooler just to protect them. And then you can fold everything up at the end of the day. The legs fold up nice, so it's compact. You can fold up both sides. And then when I set this over the hole, we drill in. It's gonna be offset a little bit. And what we do is we put slush in the triangle in the back. You're going to have this triangle back here. I pack that all full of slush, and then I pack slush around it on both sides too, and that just helps keep everything supported. They're very, very light, so it's nice to pack them in and keep them fixed in place. Now, as far as rigging these up, we usually run the Suffix no-freeze line on there, because this isn't a tip-up that you're going to fish in super cold conditions. You're basically fishing this one when it's, you know, mild conditions, so we try to run everything in our advantage that we can. That no freeze line seems to do a really nice job. If you are a guy that wants to put it out there all the time, definitely check out our heated tip up. That one's going to do everything you want it to do in all conditions. So, but it's very important that you watch our tips for use video. This is just some
overview of things. So definitely go to the next video, watch that tips for use video. I can't emphasize enough how important it is to follow everything that we say on there. The guys that are buying these that are doing everything that we say, they're just absolutely blown away. If you're skipping a couple of those things in that system, you're probably not going to catch quite as many fish. That number 20 treble hook, you know, we run light line on there as well. I guess I didn't mention that, but we run like a 6-pound fluorocarbon or like a 6-pound Stren Magnathan, which is 4-pound diameter, 6-pound strength. And then we always run that little tiny number 20 treble hook. And if you're cutting corners, you think that an 18 is going to work. It will on the days when they're biting, but on the days when they're not biting, when everybody says they're not biting, those are the days that it pays big dividends to have all of those systems in place. And throughout the course of the season, you're going to find out. It's going to make a huge difference. Everybody loves them. They rig them up their own way. But when they do everything that we tell them, they just come back and they want more, and they're absolutely floored at how many fish they're catching. So we've been doing this a long time, but definitely keep an eye on that. Follow us on Facebook. We're always giving you updates. Sometimes we're inviting people to come out and fish with us. So it's very important to follow us. That being said, we thank you for your business and stay safe on the ice this season, guys.